Hello students, again welcome in our video lecture series for economics for class 11. In our last lecture, we were doing one of the economic reforms, namely privatization. We discussed both its positive and negative sides. Today we will do the second economic reform, liberalization. Liberalization is made from the word liberty, and liberty means freedom. As discussed earlier in this chapter, rules and regulations which were framed to regulate the economic activities itself became major hindrances in the growth and development of the economy. Liberalization was introduced to end these restrictions. It was introduced to open up various sectors of the economy. Actually, liberalization means relaxation of previous government restrictions. Thus, when government liberalizes trade, it means it has removed the tariff, subsidies, and other restrictions on the flow of goods and services between countries. Reforms were made in many major sectors of the economy under liberalization, like reforms in industrial sector, reforms in financial sector, reforms in trade and investment policy, fiscal or tax reforms, and foreign exchange reforms. Today we will do the major reforms in all these five sectors. Let's start first with the industrial sector reforms. As we have earlier seen that during 1950 to 1990, agricultural and industrial growth was not remarkable. So, in the industrial sector, following reforms were undertaken after new economic policy 1991. First measure was abolition of industrial licensing, because prior to 1991, every entrepreneur had to get permission from government to start a firm, to close a firm, or to decide the amount of goods that could be produced. In obtaining such license, the entrepreneurs uses to lose their most of the important time. If this time could be utilized in expanding their business, it might be proved successful. It might be proved of some worth. Therefore, according to new economic policy, industrial licensing was abolished for all products with few exceptions. At present, there are only 6 industries which needs compulsory licensing, and these are health related. These are alcohol, cigarettes, hazardous chemicals, electronic aerospace, defense equipment, industrial explosive, drug and pharmaceuticals. That is, if you have to industrialize these 6, you have to take compulsory license. Second reform in industrial sector was that the public sector was opened to private sector. As prior to 1991, private sector was not allowed in many industries, as the major control was of the government. It was felt that government cannot control everything. It was felt that there is no need to be controlled everything by government. So, many commodities which were being produced in public sector only were allowed to be produced in private sector also. The private sector was allowed to participate in growth object of the country, and now only 3 industries are reserved for the public sector. That is, 3 industries cannot be undertaken by the private sector, and these 3 are atomic energy generation, railway transport, and the substances notified by the government of India. Remember, earlier the defense equipments could be produced only in the public sector, but today the production of defense equipments is de-reserved, means it is allowed to private sector with certain conditions. Conditions may be regarding capital investment in this sector and foreign participation. Third reform in industrial sector is price determination by market forces. Prior to 1991, the price was fixed in the industry as per the directions of the government. But due to new economic policy, now in many industries, the market has been allowed to determine the prices through the demand and supply forces. Fourth reform in this sector is import of capital goods without much political interference. Prior to 1991, there were so many restrictions on import of certain capital goods. And these restrictions slow down the production of consumer goods in the absence of availability of capital goods in the adequate quantity. But now there is liberty to import capital goods and technology in order to develop strong infrastructural base of the country. Now automatic clearance with some conditions is given to the import of capital goods. Fifth reform in industrial sector is that prior to 1991, some goods could be produced only in small scale industries. But now this restriction has been removed. So these were all the improvements in industrial sector. Now reforms in financial sector. Financial sector reforms mainly relate to three categories: banking sector reforms, stock exchange operations reforms, and insurance sector reforms. Reforms in financial sector aimed at providing greater autonomy to the financial institutions. The various reforms in this field are as follows. Number 1. Prior to 1991, Reserve Bank of India was a regulator means controller. It used to fixed interest rate, imposed quantitative restrictions on credit flows, kept high reserve requirements under cash reserve ratio and statutory liquidity ratio, that is each and every decision of the banks was in the hands of RBI. RBI, instead of being a friend, philosopher and guide to the financial institutions, became controller of financial institutions. These restrictions resulted in inefficiency of the banks, due to which banks yield low or negative profits. Therefore, reforms were undertaken. With the new economic policy, the aim was to reduce the role of RBI from regulator to facilitator of financial sector. It means to allow the financial sector to take its various decisions without consulting RBI, and these reforms were successful in some aspect. Second reform in financial sector was establishment of private sector banks. Prior to 1991, private sector banks were not encouraged, as public sector was given more dominant and important position in government policies. But after reforms, private sector banks were established, Indian as well as foreign, and they provide valuable services to the society and the economy. Third reform in financial sector is that prior to 1991, approval of RBI was required to set up new branches by the banks. But now banks which fulfill certain conditions and criteria are given freedom to set up new branches without the approval of RBI. Fourth reform in financial sector was that prior to 1991, foreign investment in Indian financial markets was restricted. With reform policies, now foreign direct investment in banks was raised. Foreign institutional investors such as merchant bankers, mutual funds and pension funds are now allowed to invest in Indian financial markets under the strict guidelines of RBI. Now commercial banks have been given permission to generate resources from India. So these all were the reforms in financial sector. Now reform in fiscal sector or tax reforms. Basically, tax reforms are concerned with reforms of government revenue and government expenditure, which are collectively known as fiscal policy. As we studied earlier, the government expenditure was more than its revenue, causing fiscal deficit and national debt, resulted in heavy government borrowings. The following measures were being taken in this regard. First of all, reduction in direct taxes were made. Because prior to 1991 and also after that, there has been a continuous increase in direct taxes, that is the taxes on income of individuals and corporations. With economic reforms, It was felt that a high rate of income tax was responsible for tax evasion, for tax avoidance. It is now widely accepted that moderate rates of income tax encourage savings and voluntary disclosure of income. The rate of corporation tax has also gradually been reduced. Reform in indirect taxes. Prior to 1991, there were complexities in imposing the indirect taxes and recovering them. Now efforts have been made to reform the indirect taxes. Actually, indirect taxes are taxes levied on commodities, like sales tax is a tax on the sale of commodity, custom duty is a tax on import of commodity, excise duty is a tax on production of commodity. This way initiated to facilitate the establishment of a common national market for goods and services. Prior to 1991, it was a very complex procedure to make tax payment in terms of long distance, fixed time period, etc. Now, in order to encourage better compliance on the part of taxpayers, many procedures have been simplified. Double taxation policy has also been simplified and rationalized. This was the first important reform in the external sector to bring reforms in foreign exchange market. The measures towards it are: earlier determination of foreign exchange rate was controlled by the government, but now the government allowed the market forces to determine the exchange rate. In 1991, India was very badly hit by balance of payment crisis. In simple words, we can say that outflow of foreign exchange was more than inflow of foreign exchange. The reform in this regard was devaluation of rupee. Devaluation means reduction in the value of domestic currency in relation to foreign currency by the government. And this devaluation of rupee encourages exports and discourages import. It led to an increase in the inflow of foreign exchange. The last reform in trade and investment policy. Liberalization of trade and investment policy was started to increase efficiency and increase competitiveness in the international market and to attract foreign investment and technology into the Indian economy. Prior to 1991, there was rigid control over the trade by keeping the tariff very high. But through liberalization, quantitative restrictions on import of manufactured consumer goods and agricultural products were fully removed from April 2001. Now, tariff on imports was reduced to enhance the domestic trade and achieve economic growth. Earlier, there were heavy export duties imposed to encourage domestic production for domestic demand only. But now, export duties have been removed to increase the competitive position of Indian goods in the international market. So, students, we have done reforms in 5 major sectors through liberalization. So, we will keep our lecture till here today. Let's revise what we have done till now. In our very first lecture of this chapter, we understand the Indian economy during 1950 to 1990. We also observed the need of introducing new economic policy in 1991, as there were many shortcomings in the economy during 1950 to 1990. In our first lecture, we did privatization with its merits and demerits both. Today, in second lecture, we did liberalization as a second economic reform. Liberalization means relaxation of government policies. Liberalization was done in 5 major sectors of the economy: industrial sector, financial sector, tax reforms, trade and investment policy reforms, and foreign exchange reforms. In our next lecture, we will do the process of globalization as third economic reform. And now, thanks for today.